Hello and welcome back to 3DWonderhouse.com. I'm Patrick and today I will show you how to create a building using Blender. We will use two new tools today, the Circle Select tool and the Inset tool. Really useful, you will see in a few seconds. And we start with our cube in the middle of the 3D view, and we will increase the size of the 3D view by pressing Shift and Spacebar on the keyboard. That way we have more room to play with. I increase the size of the cube by zooming, and we start. We switch from the object to the edit mode in order to modify the cube, and we click on Face Select as we want to select the roof of the cube, and we will increase the height of the cube. We press G on the keyboard for grab, Z to tell Blender that we want to increase the size following the Z axis, and we press 2, it's OK, enter, and we have a nice building to play with. Right now we have one big face and it's difficult to add details on it in a simple way. We first go to front view, you press 1 on your numpad or you press view, and front, it's the same. We zoom in a little bit and then we use the subdivide tool. You know it already, we used it before, so we use it. Oh, before we use the subdivide tool, we have to unselect the roof. We press A to do that, and now we select the face we want to work on. Now it's okay, we can use the subdivide tool 3 times, it's okay for what I want to show you. And we press A to unselect all the faces we just created. Now we will use the Circle Select tool. You just have to press C on the keyboard, and as you can see now, when I move my cursor, I have a circle that follows it all the time. I can go everywhere, I have a circle, and I can increase or decrease the size of the circle using the wheel of my mouse or using plus and minus on my keyboard. And for today we will use a really small circle like that, it's okay, and you will see why it's so useful. In fact, we can select just left clicking on your mouse or on your touchpad, it's okay. You left click where you want to select something. As you can see, we can select just one like that, or you go in the middle of two faces and it selects them the same way. We select the door, the entrance of the building, and as you can see we just selected many different faces just by clicking on the left button. No need to press shift all the time in order to be able to select different faces at different places on the model. If you are okay with what you just selected, you press the right button. Now we will use the Inset tool. It's a funny tool, you will see, as it will create something like a frame around the border of the faces we just selected. So I press I on my keyboard, and as you can see, if I move my cursor, I can increase or decrease the size of the frame. I left click to fix the size I want, and we will extrude every frame, so you just have to press E on your keyboard. It automatically selects the axis we will use. It's the blue line you have here, and we will extrude just a little bit. You have just to type 0.1 on your keyboard and enter. Now we have these nice windows and doors at the bottom of the building. And that's it for today. You just created your first building using Blender. Congratulations! We switch back to the object mode. Now you can see it's like a real building. And if you want to create the same for the other faces of the building, you just have to repeat the process. You will see in other video we will go further with this building, but it's for another day. Next time, I will show you more funny things. See you. Bye bye.